How are you doing, guys? You read the title. Let's do this. I've just finished Dr. Michael Greger's new book titled How Not to Diet. I've been extremely busy with work and other stuff recently, and I haven't had much of a chance to make videos, but I just had to make this one now to share my thoughts on this book with you guys. Dr. Greger, founding member and fellow of the American College of Lifestyle Medicine and founder of NutritionFacts.org, also created the blockbuster New York Times bestseller, How Not to Die, and the accompanying cookbook. He follows up that paradigm-shifting entry in the nutrition literature with a foray into the diet and weight loss book arena. How Not to Diet is a diet and weight loss book, coming out on December the 10th, just in time for Christmas, and in perfect time to help kickstart a new year, new you weight loss plan, as is often the case with weight loss literature. But from my reading of this advanced copy the guys at NutritionFacts.org were good enough to send me, the parallels with other diet books end there. In How Not to Diet, Dr. Greger swaps emotional appeals for evidence, anecdotes for truly actionable advice, and testimonials for cutting-edge science. As he says himself on page 4, this is the kind of book I was made for. Complete with a note from Dr. G himself, and well aware of the precedent set by his previous books and work on NutritionFacts.org, I was psyched to discover the groundbreaking science of healthy, permanent weight loss, being all too aware not only of the growing problem of overweight and obesity here in Ireland, but also how the problem goes on to increase the risk of chronic disease, and especially given how hard it is to keep weight off after losing it. So how does the book live up to its promise? Does it deliver facts, not filler, fantasy, or fluff? And importantly, is it something I would recommend to my patients, or to you watching this video? I'd first of all like to say that everything about this book rails against your typical diet book. From the content, to the size, to the amount of text, but don't let that put you off. If it seems a bit much at first, you could skip right through to Dr. Greger's 21 tweaks to start implementing his recommendations right away. There are also food for thought summaries at the end of each section that sum up the actionable advice covered in that section. But the book is such an interesting, entertaining, and easy read that it will likely grab you once you finish the introduction anyway, and this is the way to get the most from this book. Since once you understand the mechanism behind each piece of advice and have an awareness of the level of evidence there is to back it up, you'll be all the more motivated to fully commit to it. Indeed, Dr. Greger admits himself that this book turned out to be a much bigger undertaking than even he was expecting. I can attest to this, having covered the topic of diet and weight loss before. What I planned on being a quick overview rapidly evolves into a detailed three-part series as I uncovered some of the huge amount of research during my own reading on the topic. The amount of work that has gone into every chapter, every paragraph, even every sentence of this book is massively impressive to me, and to the casual reader can be easily grasped by the frequency of references, averaging almost 10 per page, each indicating a scientific work that was read, critically appraised, and woven into this work by Dr. Greger and his team. The amount of effort that has gone into this book is truly mind-boggling. The nigh on 5,000 references are not even included physically in the book, since it would have almost doubled its size, but will instead be available online via a QR code by the time of release. Given this level of detail and comprehensiveness, I can guarantee that there'll be stuff in here that will be new to even the most seasoned nutrition expert. There'll be tips, techniques, and strategies in these pages that will be brand new to you no matter how much you might have previously read up on weight loss or however many diet books you've bought before. Even early on in the book, you might be very surprised, as I was, as to just how much of an issue our obesity problem has become. The problems with some of the remedies that have been used so far, including issues with bariatric surgery, and the level of impotence of public health policy and scale of pushback from big industries against attempts to fight this epidemic. The book then moves on to part two, which explores all the key factors that might go into a perfect sustainable weight loss program. This highly evidence-based section provides the tools to allow you to assess weight loss diets for yourself for likelihood of effectiveness, including parameters such as glycemic load, caloric density, satiety, and effect on the intestinal microbiome, and helps shine some light on why most weight loss strategies and diets inevitably fail, and what you can do about it. These 17 key ingredients for an optimum weight loss diet are added to four more factors important for long-term weight control, including satiety, sustainability, and nutritional completeness. And the 21 total elements are used to define the optimal weight loss diet, Dr. Greger describes in part 3. Part 4 is truly an exciting prospect for dieters out there that are partial to that one weird trick we used to see cropping up all over the internet, or that might not be fully ready to commit to wholesale changes in what they eat, but want to start off with some smaller changes that can be made to any diet, and especially for those who may have given up hope following multiple attempts at weight loss, even attempts at losing weight on a plant-based diet. This is the section in which Dr. Greger documents every evidence-based tip, trick, tweak, and hack he has uncovered through years of scouring the medical literature, as he says himself. These boosters are arranged in a way that will appeal especially to those of us who appreciate things like checklists and personalization, allowing you to customize your own portfolio of techniques that work best for you. Dr. Greger stresses that this section is supposed to be used as an adjunct to a solid baseline of a healthy, dare I say, boring weight loss diet. But it is nonetheless exciting to read about and discover some of these novel and unexpected weight loss boosters. This section will be especially pertinent to those who may have encountered the all too common problem of resistant weight loss, or just want to realize their body weight goals that little bit quicker. It includes the highly anticipated chapters on ketogenic diets and intermittent fasting from Dr. Greger that are such hot topics at the moment, and they are certainly worth the wait. Indeed, these sections are like microcosms of the entire book, guiding the reader through vast swathes of science and research, whilst being easy and fun to read, allowing you to draw your own conclusions and implement as much or as little of the techniques and advice as you like. There are many other fascinating sections in this part, including details on how you can activate your so-called ileal break, how to position your bed at night to increase weight loss, and the recent revelations in the field of chronobiology, that is, the study of our body's daily mental, physical, and emotional cycles. Without giving too much away, here you will find details on how best to time meals, answers to perennial questions about the importance of breakfast, and how we can work with our body's natural rhythms to accelerate weight loss, including the apparent triple benefit of front-loading our calories. There's plenty in here that will be brand new to even the most dedicated follower of Dr. Greger's videos. There's even a section on Dr. Walter Longo's fasting mimicking diet, which many people might be keen to read. I would also like to draw special attention to the way Dr. Greger addresses two important topics in the weight loss world especially plagued with misinformation: the relative importance of genetics and the role of exercise in weight loss. The overemphasis of these two factors persists because it suits big interests to keep the public misinformed on them, and he does a particularly good job of addressing both throughout this book. Dr. Greger closes out the book with a section dedicated towards putting all of this science into action. This will eventually be added into Dr. Greger's Daily Dozen app in a special weight loss section that will enable you to implement all of this science into your daily life with a simple checklist, just like we can with the Daily Dozen. There is so much actionable, evidence-based advice and such a wealth of practical tips presented in this book that you won't be able to help but lose weight. Overall, How Not to Diet is a perfect blend of science, advice, and practical tips on diet and weight loss. This book is the real New Year, New You investment, something you can get really excited about and fully on board with, and I promise you, you won't be disappointed. But more than that, this book is perfectly poised to bring a healthy dietary pattern to a whole new cohort, and hopefully many more people will become empowered not only with the knowledge they need to achieve sustainable weight loss, but lifelong health as well. Given all of this, in addition to the fact that you can go into as much or as little detail as you want whilst resting assured that the advice you're putting into action is evidence-based and proven to work, yes, I would recommend this book to my patients and to you watching this video. Whether you're after exciting new tools and tricks, if you like the structure of a checklist and customization, if you've failed previous attempts at weight loss, if you're hoping to shed a few pounds after Christmas, or just looking to maintain a healthy weight in this world of fattening food choices we live in, there will be something for everyone in here, regardless of where you are in your weight loss journey or what level of motivation you have. Everyone's going to be talking about this book, so if it sounds like something you might be interested in, make sure you get your copy early. I hope you enjoyed this review. If you found it helpful, give us an old thumbs up there and subscribe for more reviews and other stuff. I'll leave a link to buy How Not to Diet in the description box in case you're interested. Let me know in the comments if you're thinking about giving it a look. That's it for now though, guys. Talk to you soon. Sláinte.